Hello and greetings from Iceland. I have big news today. And I'm starting this update with a question from my last volcano update. Or is it a coincidence to see uptick in seismic activity on the Reykjanes peninsula after large earthquakes in Bárðarbunga volcano? And I'm saying this again since yesterday a magnitude 4.9 earthquake occurred in Bárðarbunga and we didn't have to wait for long to see the Reykjanes peninsula respond with over 1,000 earthquakes since this morning, Wednesday. Six of them were larger than magnitude 3, just north of the town Grindavík, just by the Blue Lagoon, so it's the same trend again. But I will cover it as such in a separate video that Bárðarbunga volcano deserves, and let's see what's going on in Grindavík. The civil protection has already declared a level of uncertainty, and the main question now has to be, is this seismic swarm the trigger? The trigger that makes the seismometer graph look like this until the fire comes up. So has the countdown started? And I'm actually not sure. But things can of course change very fast. One more magnitude 4 plus earthquake and we might be heading into a new reality. But as for now I don't think the magma is close enough to make this into a matter of days. First we need some more land uplift. And I'm leaving a link to the GPS stations where you can see it yourself, what's going on. The inflation epicenter seems to be under Faradalsfjall again, and the inflation is going quite fast actually, and it's 4 centimeters now. And since Grindavík and the region where 2 days earthquakes took place is a worst case scenario, I'm hoping that they were just triggered by tension in the crust, and we have seen that before. And it is good news that when we look at the last few hours, the seismic unrest seems to be moving back to Faradalsfjall. And if I were to guess today where the fire comes up this time, which is actually still too early, I would say it's going to be close to the eruption site from 2021. Perhaps further south, or in this valley, that was actually shaking a lot when the 2021 eruption was coming to an end. And started to shake again recently. This is a place that I would be looking at now. But then the magma could just solidify somewhere on the way and stop, like in December 2021. And there is always this chance that the magma could come up elsewhere, like closer to town. I was there with the thermal drone just a while ago, during my last tour to Reykjavík. It was actually a bit more sun and warmer outside than I preferred for a thermal scan, but I did manage to find some strong heat signals there, but I don't think it has anything to do with the situation now. This tour was first and foremost about to capture some of the before shots, or shots to use if I would have to do a thermal scan there during yet another magma inflation chapter that looks as it's going all the way, like in May last year. In such case, the before footage could be very useful, but let's hope that I won't need it. However, it is getting colder now, making it easier to scan larger areas, and that is what I need. I noticed quite many spots there that I would like to check better. So, I would like to go to Reykjavík again soon, or after I get my car fixed from the last tour that turned out to be quite hard on me, and the drone that had an incident, let's say that. But the drone has been fixed already, so I was actually hoping to get some peace and quiet now to go through some online seminars, so this is not getting simpler for me. I also have to admit that I'm a bit worried about the location. During the last eruption I had to hike 20 kilometers with a stuffed backpack, and I have to admit I'm not the hiking type. The only things that get me going is something spectacular like live volcanoes. So when I got back from a last volcano hiking tour, I placed an e-bike on my wish list that is on my support page. And like I expected, it's gonna take me a while to get it funded, but it's still there and a good way to support my channel. But overall, I'm getting ready to document yet another eruption as a part of this long story. So if you are thinking about to come to Iceland to witness an eruption for the first time or coming again, now is the time to start thinking about booking. There was, however, an interview with a volcanologist today, and he was saying that if those magma channels that are already there will be going through yet another recycle period, we might be looking at a longer eruption than just 2 or 3 weeks, like eruption number 2 and 3. So it's way too early to get too stressed about this. Although I do admit that to stand in front of a live volcano is like nothing else. So let's hope for a good location, no harm to people or infrastructure. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.
No.